द अक्यूज नारायण कांबळे एज 65 चार्ज अंडर इंडियन पिनल कोड सेक्शन 306.
कोड इज प्रॉब्ली वन ऑफ द मोस्ट ऑब्जेक्टिव फिल्म्स आई हैव एवर सीन इन माय लाइफ. ऑब्जेक्टिव इन द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द कैरेक्टर्स एंड अस एज द व्यूअर्स. इट फॉलोज द ट्रेडिशन ऑफ नियो रियलिज्म ऑफ विच इंडियन सिनेमा हैज बीन मोस्ट डेडिकेटेड टू एंड मेड अ लॉट ऑफ प्रोग्रेस इन. From Ray to Bimal Roy to Benegal to Nilani to Gulzar to Ritesh Bhatt and now to Tamhane, these films, though not as popular, are very well received and appreciated by those who see them. All characters meet in the courtroom to resolve the premise, which is very Kafkaesque but in an Indian context, combined with the caste system and outdated colonial laws.
As for the Dramatic Performances Act, which my colleague cited as grounds for rejecting bail, Your Honor, it's a Victorian law dating back to 1876. And it's up to our judgment about its relevance in a post-colonial country.
No, but this is not a valid argument. It is the law, it is there.
Kamleji is arrested by the police because he's a member of the revolutionary groups fighting for workers' rights on the charges that a sewage worker killed himself based on his songs. Even after requesting our patience, Tamhane makes it clear in the early part that he will not give us filmy judgments, big climaxes and passionate arguments. I would describe the plot as cyclical, as Kamble is granted bail but again arrested on even more absurd charges. The court proceedings then are halted temporarily.
No, the summer vacation from tomorrow is for sessions court only. You can still go to the high court.
Then we see the judge going for vacations with his friends, who are salarymen like him but looking to own the means of production, that is, to start their own business. The cinematography mostly consists of wide shots so as to detach us from the character as much as possible and place them not in front of the camera but in the middle of the self-sustained world. In the early part, we see the story of the lawyer who is defending Kamble. He is a social activist and dedicated to his cause. Since he is defending a good man, we should, throughout the film, sympathize with him, but Tamhane doesn't let us. At the same time, the lawyer goes to clubs, buys expensive food from upper class grocery stores. This contradiction of both left and right qualities is what makes a character three-dimensional. The opposite strategy is employed for the public prosecutor. Since she is determined to beat the guy who we are introduced to in the beginning and have formed a subconscious attachment with, we are to term her as the antagonist. Tamhane then places us in her life where she discusses how expensive olive oil is with a stranger. Enjoy Maharashtrian nationalist plays.
तुम्हा परप्रांतियांना आम्ही डोक्यावर बसवून ठेवलाय हे तुम्ही आमचे उपकार माना. मनात आणलं ना तर मराठी माणूस कोणाची आयमाय एक करू शकतो, कोणाची आयमाय काढू शकतो.
We get to see how difficult her life is and begin to feel her aim to defeat Kamble is not personal, but that she is a minor part of the system and only looking to get higher up in this ever unfairly competitive world.
आमचे केस घ्या ना नारायण कांबळे वाले 20 वर्ष डांबाणी संपवा मॅटर पण त्याच त्याच गोष्टी तेच तेच चेहरे.
The reasons that her demeanor in court is jargonistic and cold that leads her to cite obscure laws such as these are that the education system built in the Indian society focuses on rote learning. The judge also is a sweet servant of the system. He finds happiness in the exaggerated salary packages of IIM, meaning whatever the media houses say, he will gladly accept, but only those views which support his conservatism.
You have come wearing sleeveless top to the court hearing. This is against the code of conduct in court.
And show the dreams of going up in the social hierarchy. Gradually, the movie builds up to give facts like these. The facts are that no one is good, no one is straight. It gives us multiple Indias that exist at the same time in one India and the multiple people that have to live every day in them. I found this scene to be the most chilling throughout the movie. She is the wife of the dead sewage worker. And during the car ride back to her home, she asks him this.
वैसे भी हाथ में मेरे कुछ काम नहीं है और ये सब करेंगे तो जो है वो भी चला जाएगा. एक तो मैं गांव चले गई तो मेरा सब काम छूट गया. मेरे लिए काम होगा तो बताओ.
हाँ मैं बताऊंगा.
मैं किधर भी काम करने के लिए तैयार हूँ.
The awkwardly visible distance between them, both in the car and metaphorically, He is happy to offer her money, and this is the true embodiment of the upper classes. While they are happy to occasionally donate small amounts like this and to charities, the last thing they want to see is real economic change in the society. The next shot of the slum shows us that while we like to fictionalize dystopian movies and video games to amuse ourselves, these people are already living in it. We are rendered into the role of the judge, and it is these facts that we have to assess, not on the basis of any parameters or acts or laws, but only and only on a humanistic level. Still, whatever we decide will not be entirely pure, as Tamhane's sympathy lies with the left to a certain extent. But he is careful in not to let it cloud our judgments by showing everything objectively. This is the most interesting theme of the movie. How much India as a whole is objectively appropriate to dissect, and how much of a role an author plays to turn that objectivity into subjectivity. That will decide our judgment, not only in the cinemas, but outside of it as well.
Thank you.